And welcome back. My next guest is Gyan Dutt, who's the Global Portfolio Manager for Power Electronics at McDermott Alpha. Welcome, Gyan. Nice to see you. Thank you for coming in.
Thanks, Trevor. Okay. Great talking to you again.
Yeah. So we're going to be discussing the topic of sintering today. Sintering is a technology that's been around for a long time, as we just mentioned, but it's having a resurgence. What is behind the sudden resurgence in sintering as a technology?
That's an excellent question, Trevor. Well, it's, if I have to pin on one big thing, that's a big mega trend of electrification of transportation. Okay, right. So sintering, as you said, has been around forever. Mm-hmm. But what we have figured out over last few years is to do sintering at sufficiently lower temperatures and benign pressures, mm-hmm. that can withstand that the semiconductor components, these fragile dyes, gallium nitride, silicon carbide, and silicon IGBT dyes can withstand those temperatures and pressure, where you can do these processing at temperatures which are far below the melting point of silver or copper, mm-hmm. and the joint that you get lasts 10 to 30 times longer when it comes to power cycling, has thermal resistance, or which is one-third or one-fourth that of solder.
Okay.
And much higher efficiency, much lower heat dissipation loss. So that your car runs longer, mm-hmm. and lasts longer. And that's the name of the game.
Right, right. Okay, so it's really extra reliability and better thermal and performance, really. But one of the things with sintering in particular is that it does have a capital equipment component to it. You do need to outlay for these presses to be able to do it. Do you find that a bit of a barrier when you're talking to companies about it, or are they quite convinced already about the process?
Sure, Trevor. So we essentially worked with our equipment partners over the last few years to develop the ecosystem where there could be multiple sources of equipment which could do the kind of processes we want to. So right. We have been through that cycle over last decade or so, mm-hmm. and then now we have come to an inflection point where you have multiple suppliers, mm-hmm. who are producing ready to deploy mass manufacturing capable machines which can handle sintering. And if you were to make that investment in alternate technologies like soldering, mm-hmm. they're finding that with sintering, with fast cycle times, you are able to process a lot more parts. So actually, your cost of ownership is lower than processing the same things with solder, even right. though the cost of material might be more expensive in itself.
Right.
And at the end of the day, you have to pay to play to get the kind of benefits you want to achieve with sintering.
So obviously, then it's suited to a high volume environment. Mm-hmm. Where you need the throughput, basically.
Absolutely.
Yeah.
So you could process the cycle time is of the order of a few minutes, a couple of minutes. When you mm-hmm. bring the parts together, you heat them up, you press it, and boom, you have your component, versus soldering where you have to, you know, wait for like upwards of 10 minutes with all the reducing atmospheres, right. and all the nasty things that go with it. So it's a fairly rapid, mm-hmm. and user-friendly process.
Process. Okay. So what sort of alloys do you work with when you're doing sintering?
So essentially, right now, the incumbent material or the material of choice is silver. Okay.
So it's silver.
Silver. Exactly. So.
Well, that's expensive. I mean, of course, you're going to get the best conductivity with that, but I mean, it's pretty expensive.
So silver is, you know, sort of an ideal material from die attach perspective. Mm. It has very high melting point, upwards of 900 degrees Celsius. It has very high thermal conductivity.
Yeah.
It has very low electrical resistivity. So you combine these things together, mm-hmm. And then you have a material which is ideally suited for attaching these fairly expensive silicon carbide and gallium nitride dyes. So if you are paying three times the cost of your dye with silicon carbide over silicon you might as well go with the better solution for attachment and get the bigger bang for your buck, right? So that's the idea. So silver is the material of choice when it comes to sintering.
Right.
Lately, there has been some interest in copper-based materials.
Yeah.
And they are a subject of a lot of investigations. So
now, when you talk about copper, are you talking about nanocoppers, or are you talking about...
So there are different versions around, right? So the challenge with copper is, of course, oxidation, right? The smaller you go, more surface area you have, more challenges of oxidation you have to overcome. So there's a balance based on where you want to go.
Okay.
So people are investigating a whole set of materials, but right now I believe silver is here to stay.
Right, right. Interesting. Well, it's you know, I know that most of the big car manufacturers are using it, so that's testament to the technology. And it's always interesting to learn more about it. So I want to say thank you very much, Gyan, for coming in and talking to us about it today.
Sure, absolutely. Thanks, Trevor, and I enjoyed talking to you.
Thank you.
In an EMS world full of supply chain challenges, pandemics, and shifting deadlines, Global SMT TV works around the clock to keep you up to date with the latest process technologies, standards, and breaking industry news to keep you at the top of your game. Global SMT TV, bringing you one step closer to your goals.